Knowledge alone is the nectar, a motto most nobly conceived and lived up to by the Shivaji University that is named after the great warrior, His Highness Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, a land of rich cultural heritage, the historical capital of Maharashtra. Abundant with social, educational, artistic, sports, and rich cultural heritage, Kolhapur has significantly contributed to the progress of the nation. Within such a splendid extravaganza, the Shivaji University holds a prominent position in the city.
Well, I am indeed very delighted to inform you all that the Shivaji University was established in the year 1962. The first Vice Chancellor of Shivaji University, late Dr. Appasaheb Pawar, was the person who really laid down the foundation of the Shivaji University by acquiring 853 acres of land for the future development of the university.
The ancient king Chhatrapati Rajaram and Bal Krishna always aspired to have a university exclusively for Kolhapur. President of that era and educationalist Dr. Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan's gracious presence marked the inception of the university on the 18th November 1962. Chief Minister late Yashwant Rao Chavan expressed his desire that amidst the changing world, Maharashtra should sparkle like a twinkling star and the university should be one among the reasons behind it. Considering such a desire as its aim, the university began its journey with 5 departments, 34 affiliated colleges and a good number of 14,000 students.
Currently, the university has a 3 districts jurisdiction, 281 affiliated colleges and nearly 300,000 students. And it has several different faculties, nearly 9 faculties, through which several teaching learning programs have been implemented.
The faculties of science, arts and fine arts, social science, commerce, education, law, engineering and technology all together constitute about 40 departments in the university. It proudly boasts of 2,50,000 students who are pursuing their graduation, post-graduation and PhD in the university. There's a special initiative taken in the memory of the martyrs of these districts, wherein one sapling is planted in the campus area called the Kranti One. The space is exclusively dedicated to sapling plantation. This is, of course, the most benevolent way of keeping them alive in our hearts. Spread across 853 acres, the enormous university campus is very captivating due to a pleasant ambience. The university manages to conserve water through the medium of 2 wells and lake within the campus. The campus is beautifully adorned with various living creatures like 28 types of butterflies, 6 species of frogs, 14 types of animals, vultures, eagles, quelks, peacocks and migratory storks to name a few. The botanical gardens occupy about 42 acres, along with which rare medical herbs are preserved and nurtured through this notion of lead garden. A lot of research work is being made on most of these herbs. As per the national level P index ranks, the university is conferred with a 25th rank and also holds an 8th position out of 20 in the nation's BITE schools and terms of the biotechnology department. The university stands third in the field of solar research nationwide and a 20th position in material science. This is the only university in the state holding the IPLS program of the DBT. About 8 departments are currently running the DST, PERS program, and interestingly, the university is one among the 4 best of 30 universities that run the program. The university has witnessed an ever-rising progress in the research field. 8 departments through Nation Science and Technology Department for the FIST and 30 departments for SAP Research have received grants which amounts to approximately 82 crores for research purposes. The university augments various research centers, inclusive of special research centers on renowned personalities and philosophers. Socially eminent research works in Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar Research Center and Shahu Research Center are now being carried out. Barrister Bala Saheb Khardekar Library is one of the leading libraries in South Maharashtra. The library consists of more than 4 lakh books, of which about 5,000 books are limited editions of the 1716 to the 1950s era. The archive cell consists of 7,000 manuscripts such as Purana, Dharma Shastra, Vedant and Yoga. The students enjoy the smart card facility to ensure a proper use of the library. The current progress of the university completely relies on information and technology. The Department of Internet started in March 1999 in order to foster adequate development of the students. Following this, the university website started on the 20th May 2002. The admission forms, examination forms, syllabus and results of these exams are all available online. Furthermore, the data center was set up since July 2012 to reach out the internet services to the affiliated colleges of the university. Such a technology entails in it raised flooring and false ceiling, UPS 10 kVA Kirloskar make, fire alarm system and rodent repelling system, etc. Apart from activities, applications such as exam processing system, MKCL servers, TMS project, biometric processing, data servers, HPC for bioinformatics, domain name server unishivaji.ac.in, etc. facilities are provided too. University uses the software of Moodle Academic Course Management System. Paperless, time-consuming and better understanding, Moodle is a free open source for software. There are an umpteen number of courses available to which the students have an access through an ID and password. This enables them to appear for their exams from anywhere across the globe, also submit their assignments and attend audiovisual lectures to compensate for their missed classes. This also makes it easy for the university to update the students with the latest news. The examination department of the university is magnificent and self-sufficient with its special characteristics. Our center is renowned for announcing the earliest results for all courses within a span of 40 working days, which is far less than so many other universities and showcases the consistency of the department. The specially designed sophisticated locker system is another one of its kind, helping us maintain a strict security. The university has an independent technology department. Not just technology, but also various nanotechnology programs are now being nurtured.
On the occasion of Golden Jubilee, started 2 new courses. One in a frontier area of sciences, that is nanoscience and technology, which is fully financially supported by the government of Maharashtra. And also the other one on the birth centenary of late Y.P. Chauhan, that is named as Yashwant Rao Chauhan School of Rural Development.
With the grant provided by the government of Maharashtra, the Yashwant Rao Chauhan School of Rural Development has now started. The courses of Masters of Rural Studies, Masters of Social Work and Masters of Computer Application are being taught here. The construction of new buildings for mass communication, commerce and management departments is in progress. The Department of Foreign Languages has been teaching various languages like French, Russian and Japanese have been taught in the Department of Foreign Languages, whereas the Music Department teaches the traditional, classical and the Sugam Sangeet. The two departments are also engaged in research work. On this account, the university has initiated various student-centric activities such as Earn and Learn, which is motivated by the idea of Karmavir Bhavrao Patil to help the students economically too. This university is probably the only one of its kind wherein about 4 crores are spent on 414 merit scholarships conferred to the outstanding students. The competitive exams are run under the Babasaheb Ambedkar Research Center. Many students from this department are selected for the UPSC and MPSC examinations. The university has a well-equipped hostel for both boys and girls. Thus, this place proves to be a home away from home for the distant students. Amenities such as conference room and study rooms are provided too. The most important characteristics of these hostels is that the students are served the mess food on the no loss, no profit basis through the club mess run by the students themselves. The university is progressing ahead, keeping in mind its student-centric approach as well as gifting capable torchbearers to the world. It's this aim that motivated the inception of distance education. Distance education has emerged victorious in reaching out to each one, from the soldier fighting on the battlefield to the coy homemaker at home. Every year, thousands of them attain their dreams of higher studies along with work and home through distance learning facilities. About 45,000 students are currently pursuing their education through distance learning. E-learning as well as video conferencing and library facilities are available to facilitate an easy learning. The university has always excelled and achieved laurels in sports and cultural activities too, along with being academically ahead. It has the second-ranked synthetic track in the state to prepare the potential students to compete globally.
We also celebrate certain days on the campus. Earth Day, Ozone Day, No Vehicle Day, as well as we also conduct cleanliness drives on the occasion of Mahatma Gandhi Jayanti on 2nd October. I think with these kinds of achievements, we feel proud to be the students of Shivaji University, and we are all sure that everybody, those who are students of Shivaji University, will make everybody feel proud that they are the students of Shivaji University.
We look forward to being one of the most preferred and trusted educational institutions in the years to come.